A moment of meditation. Joy of Zion Church. Let's confess together. I am a spirit. I have a soul. I live in a body. I am a new creation. God loves me. God blesses me. God makes me righteous. God gives me peace that the world cannot give. I am grateful. I am thankful. I am delighted. I am happy. I am joyful. I am okay. I am doing good. In Christ, I am a person with overwhelming confidence to win in any situation and circumstance. I am a victor, not a victim. In Christ, I am a person who has the ability to control my inner climate, regardless of external circumstances. I am a spirit having the spirit. In Christ, I am a person who has the ability to maintain a positive attitude in a negative situation. I am blessed to be a blessing. I will never be the same again. Your connection with the divinity. A little one shall become a thousand, and a small one a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it in His time. Isaiah chapter 60, verse 22. What an inspiring scripture. Observe that the prophet Isaiah didn't say, a little one is a thousand. Rather, the Spirit so accurately puts it, he says, a little one shall become a thousand. It does spell growth, change, going from one level to another. That means when a little one is said to be little, it's talking about a thousand. Imagine how big that is. Proof positive that the Lord is ever interested in our growth and prosperity. How would you read this and still have doubts about your greatness and prosperity being God's idea and desire? 3 John chapter 1 verse 2 says, Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayst prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. The Bible is replete with information on the power and the glory of God, the honor, the majesty, the splendor of our Heavenly Father, and His will to share what is God with His children. This is the glorious life of prosperity you've been called to, and that's the basis of our prosperity. We aren't running after or seeking prosperity, because the truth is, we are children of this true God whose wealth is limitless, inestimable, and unquantifiable. We belong to Him. The difference between Christians who believe in and walk in prosperity and those who don't is this. The former believe in their true connection with God, knowing their sins is real. They don't need to seek prosperity. It just works in them. The latter group, however, don't understand it. Hence, they keep seeking it, trying hard to get it. And because it eludes them, they criticize it. There's no human being who doesn't want to prosper. That's a fact. The reason many work and continually seek to improve themselves is so they could have better means to take care of themselves, their families and loved ones, and help other people. Every human person wants to be able to do something, not only for himself but for others, and that's prosperity. Study the truth of God's word and accept each simple message with faith in your heart. Read about men and women described to us in the Bible, who were prosperous, influential, powerful, successful, and served God in righteousness till their days were over. They had a great life all the way. Accept growth and prosperity and walk in it. It's a function of our connection with divinity. Confession. I take advantage of my inextricable connection with my Heavenly Father. All that belongs to Him belongs to me. My prosperity is of the Spirit and it's limitless, inestimable, and unquantifiable. I am established in the Lord's righteousness, therefore I flourish like the palm tree. I walk in wealth and abundance always. Amen. I hope so much Jesus be inside you and covers you today. Have a glorious day or have a glorious night. See you tomorrow.